Let's get to it, guys. The first thing we want to do, of course, is just take a look at the action, right? And what you want to be doing is, of course, is if you need any questions, you can always hit the down arrow here and then click help. This is going to go ahead and open up a window for you to go ahead and look into different things that could really help you. I'm going to go in through a lot of this conversation right now for you, but feel free to also click in here and learn a little bit more. It has some examples that it goes through it, and I think you guys will enjoy this. Of course, how do you get that? Down clicking and hitting the help button. All right, guys, let's start it up. First things first, of course, you'll start it off, and yours might not look exactly like mine because mine has a little bit of some coloring and some things that are added to it, but like always, guys, the first thing you want to do is, of course, start a chart, right? How do we start a chart? We go to our terminal right here on the tabs, right? And you're going to be able to hit chart, right? Well, we'll start a new one, right? There it is, guys, starting a brand new one, right? And of course, yours might not look like this at first, right? Yours might look a little bit different, and you can always kind of change and adjust the scaling, right? The first thing we would want to look up is, how do we look up a symbol, right? Let's start with this, right? Well, the first way to look up a symbol, right? You're just going to go ahead and go to over to your symbol out box. You can click the box, or you could just simply click the window, and by clicking in the word or the ticker, you should be able to find the name, right? So let's say if I just wanted, you can also search by name, right? Let's say if I wanted to look up Macy's, I could search up the word Macy's, that because it's in the company name and it's going to show me anything that has M-A-C-Y, right? Well, there I see Macy's and I'm able to click on it and open to it, right? This is called the symbol lookup. And another thing important of this is you're going to want to eventually color code this symbol link so that when you see anything that is on the red, you can go ahead and link that to, of course, Macy's here. And then that way, if you have anything of your order forms or things like that, you can color code it so that it can move with it. So if I go to Macy's chart, my order form also changes over to Macy's chart. So like here, you see Picard, right? Because it's yellow. Watch when I change it to the red. Boom, immediately goes over to Macy's. All right, let's get to the next one, which is the account lookup. And you always want to make sure, of course, you have the right account selected. Right here, you're going to be able to change your accounts. And it's very important to make sure that when you're changing over your accounts, also your order forms are also changing over, right? If I go and click on a different account here, you're going to see that a change and adjustment, right? The same way, if I switch to another one, and it should change them all. One of the major things that you can do to adjust this is right here at the top on your main window, you're going to see this little person. And if I click that, if I unclick that, then when I start changing this, it won't change it completely. It won't change the order forms also. So that's why I have this selected where the little person selected so that when I change the account, I go ahead and I can change over with my another account too. And all these change over with it, right? You see the 87 and you see the 87, right? That's very important, team. Let's go looking into overlays and adding that. Well, I'll have one right over here for you guys. We can do it right here. So to add an overlay, you're going to see to the right hand of this symbol look. So we're just moving down the line, right? Now we're going to add overlay. You can see it right here. If you need to zoom in, go ahead and zoom in. You guys can see that. Clicking on that will give you an ability to put anything and overlay it over the charts. Some ways that I use this is, let's say if I wanted to look at the overall market and I can add the SPY here and see how it trades similar. So we can do this as a line, we can do this as a bar, we can do this as many different things. Sometimes I like the dotted lines or just lines themselves. So we'll do it here and let's do it in a different color. Let's do it red. And remember that you can also change the kind of the way that it's going to look, right? You can also make it less thick and things like that. Those are all things that you can kind of adjust here. And if you wanted to, you can do a specific one. I like to show the price marker, and this is going to show the price on the left-hand side, but it's all the way that you like to do it, right? So there it is, guys. Now you're starting to see the SPY with the Macy's. And we can go to a company that kind of tracks a little bit closer, like let's say Apple, right? And you can see it here, how the red line is moving with Apple, right? very similar. SPY's price, and on the right-hand side, Apple's price. This is a very good way to look for correlation in your stocks. Let's get to the next one, which is aggregation, right? Selecting the menu and the aggregation type, right? So, well, like always, guys, you guys can take a look here. And there's different ways of selecting the data, right? You can go back as far as 10 years, 20 years, right? You don't need to be in just 6 months. Feel free to click it back so you have more data ready to go to it. And then, of course, you can look down here and go through the preview. You can go back as far back here as you want, right? And that's very important for traders, especially longer term swing traders. Chart style, right? There's different styles, right? We have all different styles, and you're going to find it right here on the bar right here at the top. So this next one will give you line chart, right? You can do a line with a line, right? Then I'm looking at the SPY and just watching the price rise with it, right? This makes it simple. That's one thing I can say with lines. If you actually go and look at a Bloomberg terminal, they're going to use lines and not candles. So just something to think about, right? You can use bar charts. Bar charts are some of my favorites. The reason why is it shows you the open and close. So the left tick right here is the open and the right tick is the close. And it also gives you the range. This helps me a lot of the times take away some of the emotion in trading. Let's go to the analysis tools, all right? So there's plenty of different analysis tools. You can use volume profile. You can use VWAP plus, right? Volume profile is going to be able to go ahead and calculate a volume during this time and where it's trading, right? This is very important for traders that like to use this, right? Like to know where the volume profile is on the top-hand side and the bottom side. This is going to give us nice and support and resistance levels. I like to use, of course, certain things like that. And you can also go into kind of VWAP plus, right? VWAP plus is in a way to looking into VWAP, right? So these are all ways to definitely use this. I would definitely look into the volume profile and learn a little bit more about it if you want to go ahead and use it. As you keep going, we'll go into the next one, which is the indicator lookup. And we have tons of indicators, guys. There's tons from channels, from moving averages to even oscillators, right? And then you got your trend names, volatilities, volume studies. There's tons of these, guys. Of course, I use VWAP. I use a MACD, which would be a part of your oscillators. Then you could also take a look at moving averages, EMAs, all different types here. There's channels, Bollinger Bands, Keltner channels that I recommend looking into. So there's so many indicators, guys. There's 50 different items there for you to go through in the indicator lists, right? And don't forget, when you add one of these, you can always kind of adjust them, right? It's not just what you see here. Feel free to go and adjusting the settings, right? So you can click here or right click on it. You can change the colors on top. You can really start to kind of mess with this. And I think this is very important because if you're going to do it, fix it to the way that you want to get it set up, right? Let's say I wanted to do this as a little bit of a thicker line and really kind of see the action, right? Maybe I want to do it in a white bar, right? Things like this are going to definitely change things up, right? Now you see it completely different, right? Well, now it's a thick line. I can really see what it's doing. And you can also adjust different things, right? Don't forget that you can also kind of adjust it. And like always, just click right over here. You can go to line properties. You can also change the visibility, how things work here, the parameters. Feel free to adjust them. But I like to also just stay with the standard because that's going to help me out, right? So you can close that. You can also overlay the volume and things like that. So let's keep moving. We just talked about some of the indicators. Let's go to some of the object manager displaying the indicators and drawings applied. So let's say if you're the type of trader that you have just way too many things on. I have the Bollinger Band, right? I have, let's say I wanted to add some EMAs, right? I added some exponential moving averages. And I also had MACD, right? I was like, you know what? I'm doing it all here. I want 10 different things. I want indicators at the bottom. I want different things showing me different things. The CCI, right? And so at some point, it gets a little bit confusing, right? Well, what if you wanted to take a look at just certain things? Well, you can go to the object manager here, and this is going to go ahead and tell you, what are you really looking at, right? What do I want to look at? Well, what if I just wanted to see a one of these, right? And I'm not trying to see all of them. Well, I can take them off, right? And just remove them and just show me what I'm looking at, right? Which is the Bollinger Bands here. Or I could also do the same thing and look at the drawings, right? Resistance and support and take those off. Overlays, take off the SPY for a second. This is a great way to go ahead and adjust things and not make a mistake, kind of closing something, and then you get upset because you closed the wrong thing. I didn't want to close the MACD. Well, the big way to do that is you could just do it here. Instead of closing it, you're just unclicking here on the visible. You can always remove it also if you just wanted to take it off here. Well, great way to do it in the object manager. All right, getting through this, let's go to it. Let's get to the next one, which is talking a little bit about chart trading. Chart trading is something that I recommend you definitely do and look into, guys. I like doing chart trading. I'm going to take off some of the Bollinger Bands here and some of the EMAs so we can go back to a regular chart. Let's go to a candle chart here and talk a little bit of it. I'll take even the overlay off. But yeah, chart trading is definitely something I take a look at, guys. Right now, let's see if I can get an order into the market. I don't think I'll be able to actually get an order in here, but let me see what I can do. Of course, I'm doing this when the market's closed, but let's see if I can just get an order in here for Apple. Trading 226 by 37, 226. Just going to put an order out there just to try to do it. Of course, I got the refuse right now. But let's go to the swing trade, and then you can see some of my trades that I have on right now. So we'll go to the swing trade. We'll go to Picar, and I have some orders out there already. Let's go to the chart, of course. So you can see it didn't flip over here. Why didn't it flip over? Let's talk about that. Because this is red, and down here in the position, this is yellow. So you want to have it the same way as your charts if you want to be able to click on your positions and get them to move. So now you see MSOS. You see Picar, right? So there you guys see limit orders right here, right? And so this is my position, right? You can do a stop loss. And you can also do a target profit, right? And so these are all things that you can be doing, right? To take money off and kind of trade right on the screen. And another thing you can do is looking on the right-hand side and hitting the chart order entry. So there you guys have chart order right there on the chart, right? And so there I can be adjusting here and go to go till cancel, right? So this will keep that order out there. Until I cancel it, I can set different defaults on the order sizes. And I can even add some hot buttons. How do you add these hot buttons? Well, you might want to know this. And you're going to right-click on the screen. You're going to go to the settings. We're going to go here towards chart order entry. And you want to make sure that you have this clicked on if you're going to be using the chart order entry. You want to click show order entry. You want to hit view, close orders, right? Stop loss, target profit. This is a good way to doing it right there on the chart. I like doing this, guys. It really helps me out, especially that stop loss as I move it up into the green. And you can also have some quick trading, right? Buy market, sell, right? These are all different things that you could have out there. And you can add these hot buttons and just start to have them on there. And that way, you don't need to go far, right? I can buy the market. I can buy the offer. I can buy the bid, I can sell market, I can sell bid and sell ask. You have all buttons right here. If I wanted to close a position, cancel all, right? That way, if I have some working orders out here like this and I go and I hit the cancel all button, guess what happens? Boom, canceled, right? That's what it's all about, team. I hope that you guys can start learning how to use this. And if you have any questions, always reach out to us, right? Let's keep going. Let's take a look at some other things that I can show you guys here. Okay, and then we can take a look at mouse trading. Mouse trading is a little bit harder. I will say that, guys. Mouse trading isn't bad, though. Once you click this right here on the top, you'll be able to actually put orders with your mouse. You can see how left click here is a buy limit and right click is a sell stop, right? So you can actually use the clicks to set up where you're buying and where you're selling. This one's a little bit harder, so I definitely recommend to look into it a little bit more when you're getting into your click and mouse click trading. Another thing to make sure is when you're having mouse click trading on, make sure that you click it off when you start to click on other things, because you might end up making a purchase that you didn't mean to make. And of course, we all don't want to make that mistake. Next thing, let's take a look into the info window, right? The info window is on this top left. You can actually move it around, right? If you wanted to move it somewhere in the window, you can move it up here on the top left or right. I like it right here at the top left. You can even, if you wanted, you could put it close to the price action. I like it there. And of course, you can adjust this, right? You can go to the settings and add different things. Let's say if I wanted to add ticks or maybe a countdown or maybe the time, I can always add that on there and add different things in the info window. All right, let's keep going, team. I'll be right back.